This is the Lotus Hotel manager talking, and we just want to congratulate you on your marriage.
Oh, my marriage?
See, your marriage. Congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. Freitas, for your good marriage. It was very, very pretty, and I really liked it, and it was so good, and I loved it so much.
Why don't we get to know each other a little more? Do you two know each other's hobbies?
Yes. Caleb likes to play
the drums.
The drums! Ugh, that was at the tip of my tongue. He told me about that, but it must have been lost in his eyes.
How so considerate of you. One thing I know about Annie is that she really likes to, likes to knit.
Knit?
Oh, yeah, knitting. My favorite thing in the world. Gosh, he knows me so well.
She also likes to dance.
You're pushing it.
You couldn't remember one damn thing about me.
Okay, why don't we move on? So let's do something easier. Let's start with Annie. What is your favorite color? Caleb, please do answer with her.
Pink.
Blue.
Could I say pink? I meant blue.
Uh-huh. Okay, then, what's your favorite color, Caleb? Annie, answer with him.
Green.
Red.
I meant red. Not green. Christmas colors. Confuses me. Did I mention I'm colorblind?
Clearly you are too trying to make me believe that this marriage is working. If you're gonna lie to me, do it well. That's the least you can do. Come back and try again next week. I expect some truth next time.
I'll stick my tampon up your...
All right, nigga, listen up.
It feels like acid's pouring off my ass.
Suddenly, my day got more interesting.
Goodbye, Jane.
We have an arrest warrant.
We were exonerated.
We're here for her.
I'm never gonna get out of this place alive. I know that. I want her dead.
I'm not gonna let you see her.
You're much braver than I give you credit for.
Stay the hell away from me.
Could I even remember the drums? What goes inside that thick head of yours?
Oh, please! Who would have thought someone as stupid as you could even keep a rhythm? And what? I like to knit and dance?
And again. How could you not remember the drums? That was the only thing I said to you that actually mattered.
When did you tell me about your stupid drums? All right, next question. Any hobbies?
I play drums.
You see, due to your lack of motor skills, I don't believe that.
Nah, honest, I've been playing since I was 10.
Wow, a man of many talents. Can you sing too?
I sing like Bieber on crack. In other words, no.
That I can believe.
Ha ha. Enough about me. Let's talk about your jobs and hobbies. From your personal experience, which corner street pays the best?
Asshole.
And what, you're colorblind? Really?
I told you my favorite color was blue. I told you thousands of times, and you said pink. How do you get those mixed up?
How do you get red and green mixed up? Christmas colors? No wonder she didn't believe us.
So it's my fault?
Oh no, it's Santa Claus's fault. No, of course it's your fault.
Well, fine.
Fine.
Fine!
No, I get the last say in this. Fine! I'm so tired of this. I can't stand this. The stupid court guy just had to put us together for 6 months for us to be enduring each other and being real woman and wife. I don't give a crap. Honestly, I've thought multiple times of forgetting the money and just leaving this girl. She's unbearable. Every little thing I do, she yells at me or criticizes me. She won't leave me alone.
No, dude, think about the money. The money is the only reason you're in this mess.
Have you tried living with this damn woman? She's insufferable. She's gonna kill me before the court date.
What does she do?
She always tells me to shut up. She won't let me do what I want to do, even though this is my house. She makes me clean, Kian. She makes me clean, and then she gets mad at me for leaving the toilet seat up. If it bothers you so much, why don't you just leave the damn house, you know?
So annoying. He always leaves the toilet seat up. No matter how many times I tell him to put it down, it's always up. And you wouldn't believe how dirty his house is. He never cleans. I had to force him to get up from the couch and at least wash his hands.
Is this all worth it for the money?
Yes.
Then stop complaining and leave me alone.
No, it's my venting time. You have to listen to me. I get that this is his house, but we're going to end up paying the monthly bills at the end of the day, you know? Would it kill him to turn on the heater? This crap apartment, you can afford heat. It's freaking cold.
Go stand in the corner.
Why the hell would I do that?
The corner is 90 degrees. I don't know how anyone would want to live with her. Better yet, marry her.
Don't let her get to you. Just think about the money. Try to make her give up, leave the house, divorce you.
What do you think I've been doing the past week? You've been annoying me lately.
Why?
You do this thing where you always wear clothes, and it's actually really starting to bug me.
Go to hell. I love...
Me?
Don't interrupt me. I was going to say I love ice cream.
See? You're heading in the right direction.
She's gonna have to give up sooner or later, because I'm not stopping until she does. Alright, I gotta go.
I need to get rid of him.
Oh, how about you tell your parents to visit you? All your past boyfriends ended up crying and breaking up with you the minute they saw your parents. Caleb might just run away and forget the money.
You're so right. Parents, why didn't I think of that?